Okay, this is our deck, our sunroom. And we are safe, everyone. I don't want anyone to worry. We're not going to put ourselves... This is Grand Lake. Oh, boy.
In many communities along the southern regions, water levels haven't yet reached the highest forecasted levels. They are forecasted to continue to rise. I would characterize it as essentially seeing the worst of Mother Nature, but in many ways, the best of human nature.
The best of human nature, because so many people are pitching in, helping each other out. This, a look at some of that assistance. Pictures posted online by a local MLA. Now, that update coming from the director of New Brunswick's emergency services, who warns that a bad situation due to severe flooding is expected to get worse.
We have a new factor in the game today, and that is wind. The winds are causing an impact on rescue and evacuation efforts, and storm surge effects that just add additional damage to property and possessions.
Strong winds, a major factor for power outages in the region. More than 20,000 customers are in the dark, most around Moncton and Fredericton. This is the historic flooding is now in its second week. The province's emergency measures organization says so far more than 100 metric tons of sand and about 350,000 sandbags have been distributed, flooding forcing more than 700 people from their homes. And that number could climb, especially for those living near the St. John River system. The St. John Emergency Management Organization warns that for that city, floodwaters are expected to rise through to at least Monday.
Currently in St. John, the flood level is 5.5 meters. And we still expect it to be over 6 meters when we include the tidal information in the next coming days.
And officials are encouraging residents in hard-hit areas to leave their homes now before water levels climb even higher.
If people have stayed in their homes, they're hardy souls. But they are going to find, at least in the southern regions, that their challenge is not going to go away for some time.
The Red Cross is on the scene helping those in need. And anyone who wants to help people in New Brunswick, the Red Cross is accepting donations online. Their website, redcross.ca.